Audio Bookshelf presents Iron Thunder by Avi and read by Tyler Greenlaw.
April 13th, 1861. The New York Herald. The war begun. Very exciting news from Charleston. Bombardment of Fort Sumter commenced. The summons to Major Anderson to surrender. Major Anderson's refusal. Terrible fire from the secessionist batteries.
Chapter 1. How it began.
Tom, we just need more money. You're going to have to take your pa's place.
It was a cold, early evening in January 1862, and the war had been going 10 months. But only a week had passed since we'd learned that my pa had been killed fighting in some town in Maryland. We didn't know where exactly, no more than we knew if his remains would be returned. The only thing we did know was that he was gone. Forever. Ma and I halted at the dim bottom steps of the shabby York Street tenement, where we lived in the Vinegar Hill section of Brooklyn. I'd been carrying home one of her laundry loads. So, when she sent my older sister, Dora, on up ahead, telling her to light the wood stove, I thought she just wanted to take a rest. The 3 flights up to our rooms always tired her. Her words gave me 2 feelings. Some kind of pride she'd consider me able, but upset that she'd ask me to take over from Pa. I didn't see how I could. His dying left me sad and angry, too, at the Army, at the Union, at President Lincoln for taking my Pa away and altering our lives in ways I could not know. Getting a job was the first big change. Like lots of boys, I'd been peddling newspapers, the Herald, around the neighborhood. You could pull in buyers if you called out the war headlines right. I may have been small for my 13 years, but I was loud. Thing is, since I had to buy the papers before I sold them, I made maybe 35 cents a week. The best corner was right outside the Brooklyn Navy Yard gates, but Garrett Folloy, being the biggest newsboy around, had that one. I was going to the local school. Well, some days, at least. Liked it fair enough. Learned to read, anyway. What kind of work you figure I could get? I said, adding, and I won't join no army. She looked at me so mournful, I wished I hadn't spoken.
Tom, she whispered, you know I wouldn't want that.
We all knew what was happening with the rebellion. About 10 months ago, when Mr. Lincoln became president, 11 southern states left the Union, claimed they were an independent country, named themselves the Confederate States of America. Rebels, or secesh, is what we called them. Back in April, they began the war by firing on Fort Sumter down in South Carolina. When the war began, lots of neighborhood men and boys signed up for Brooklyn's 14th Regiment. My father did. Maybe they believed in the Union, like my pa. I supposed it was the pay, too. We needed money, and a private made $13 a month. The truth is, no one thought the war was going to last so long or be so bloody. But by early winter, though newspapers said otherwise, folks knew the war wasn't going well. Not for the Union. Lots, like my pa, had been killed. We got along because Ma and my sister each earned about $2 a week by taking in officers' washing from the nearby Navy Yard. But my sister made less because she got sick a lot. So I knew my Ma was right. We needed more money. What do you think I could do? I asked.
I spoke to the yardmaster today, she said. Mr. Hendricks. He might need help.
Doing what?
Not sure, she said. Said I should just bring you around tomorrow.
Trudging upstairs that night, I had no idea what would happen. I felt like an ox must when a yoke is thrown over its neck for the first time.
I supposed school was over, but if you'd told me then I was going to be part of the most amazing adventure of the whole war, I'd have called you a liar, flat out. Except it was no lie. I was there. I saw it all. Chapter 2. I get a job on I don't know what. It was still dark next morning when I heard Tom.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.